Here's how to step up your Google Calendar productivity. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and more Google content than your heart could desire. Today, I'm pulling back the curtain to show you how I organize my Google Calendar. And yes, this will include some of my favorite productivity and time blocking tips. Let's go. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you my Google Calendar. So this is my personal Gcal, but I have all my business events locked and loaded in here as well. This is really my whole life in here. So as you can see from this week, I've got my entire work days and then some all blocked out in Google Calendar as well as color coded, which I'm gonna get to in a little bit. On the left, I've got important time zones at a glance and all my different calendars here. Now, I use Google Calendar to make sure I have enough time in my day for all of the events and tasks that I need to get done. So you're gonna notice my Gcal isn't just meetings with other people. A lot of it is blocked for my own personal tasks that I need to accomplish throughout my day. When I say tasks, I mean anything from general work things, like events that I need to get done in my day, to actual tasks and reminders I've set with Google. It's all in my Gcal. So it would probably be helpful for you to understand how I structure my work days on this calendar. I run a video production company, Brio Media, and under that umbrella, I have quite a few different streams of work that I need to keep organized in this Google Calendar. So first, every single week, I produce a YouTube video, like this one you're watching right now. Hi. I've also got specific clients that I do video production for, and then I've got a couple of podcasts I produce as well. And I'm gonna get into how I optimize my schedule in a little bit. So all of this, plus whatever appointments, fun outings, or anything else personally I have planned, are all here in one central spot. Told you my entire life is organized in Google Calendar. So let's move to another week down the line that doesn't look quite as crazy as this one. So we can start time blocking in Gcal. And just so you know, I typically reserve time on Thursdays and Fridays to finish time blocking the following week. But you can use whatever schedule works for you to get the most out of your time blocking and to keep you on track and organized. So here we are on another week. I know I have a shoot on this day. So what I want to do is block some time the day before so that I can prep for the shoot. So I'll just click on Wednesday and we will call it shoot prep. Here I could add any notes in if needed, and then I'm just gonna hit enter. So now everybody in my organization that I've shared my Google Calendar with will see that I'm busy from 11 to 11:30 a.m. So not only is time blocking helpful for you to stay organized, but it also helps your team members or family or friends or whoever you've shared your Google Calendar with to stay organized, because once they have access to your Google Calendar, they're gonna be able to see your exact availability. And more on this in just a quick second. So if someone is trying to block time with you, they're gonna see that you're busy at, say, this time. And the same is true if you have your Gcal linked to a scheduling tool like Calendly or something. It's gonna show that you're busy. Another important reason that you're gonna want to ensure you're keeping organized and time blocking properly in Google Calendar is because of the notifications you're gonna get. So these really do help keep me on track. So when you create an event in Gcal, it's automatically going to be set to remind you 10 minutes before. You can change this by clicking on that notification option. You can delete the notification altogether or set a different notification time. Everything from 5 minutes before up to a day before. Or set a custom reminder. So if it's a really big event, you can actually add an additional notification if you find that helpful. So this is really handy for me. It's something I do often. And if you ever wanted to set a reminder the day before and then say like an hour before the event, easy to do so here. Something else I recommend when it comes to time blocking is you block everything. Here's what I mean. I even have my lunches blocked in Gcal. Sometimes I put my workouts in there, things like that, non-work related things to ensure that it is on my schedule and it is going to happen. Another function I find most helpful and time-saving when I'm time blocking in Gcal is the repeat functionality. So every Thursday is podcast recording day for me. So maybe we can click to create an event and then we're going to set this podcast publish task to repeat every single Thursday at this time. So click on the does not repeat option, and then in this drop down, you're gonna have a bunch of preset options like weekly, monthly, and things like that. Or you can select custom and choose your custom repeat schedule. And I want it to last to infinity, though you could set an end date here as well if you want. So we just have to hit enter, and there we go. It's now been added to my calendar every Thursday for me. So I don't have to go in and every Thursday add this. So remember I talked about appearing busy to your friends or colleagues or family that you've shared your calendar with, and I wanted to touch on something very important. One of the most important things to keep in mind when it comes to time blocking is that people you've shared your calendar with will only see you as busy for the events you've added to that shared primary calendar. So here's what I mean. On the left here, you're gonna notice I've got a whole whack of calendars. These are other calendars that I've enabled or added. So as an example, people in my general organization that are shared on my Tasia Custode calendar wouldn't see this mom physio time block because that was created using a different calendar I made called mom's appointments. So here, I can toggle on and off this view for you. So when I toggle it off, you'll see it disappears from the calendar. So none of these other calendars would set me as busy for someone else. Only what's in my Tasia Custode calendar will, that I've shared with those people. So this is important to keep in mind because I've seen people organize their calendar by creating a lot of different calendars here per, say, task or client or maybe even deadline or by content creation days, etc. But this is really great if that's what works for your visual organization. But then you would have to share all those separate calendars with your team or family so that they can see all of those things on your schedule. So you and everybody else would have so many calendars toggled on all the time. So to me, it's easiest to keep most of my personal and business all within my one primary Tasia Custode calendar and then simply share that one calendar with whomever I need. Make sense? But you might be wondering, how do I have all these lovely colors organized on my calendar if most of these are set to my personal calendar, which you can see here is denoted in a pink color? Well, you can quickly change the event color in Google Calendar regardless of the calendar that the event belongs to. So you're gonna notice I'm obviously a big fan of color coding in my calendar blocking organization in Gcal. First, you can set the color of an event when you are creating it, of course. So I have my Gcal colors organized by client. That way I can tell at one glance of the color of the task, which clients this task is for. I also have it organized per task. So say my editing tasks are in gray. I know that is always an editing task at a quick glance. What can I say? I'm a visual learner, but you can color block in Gcal to whatever works for you. Is it by client? Is it by project? Or maybe it's by task or category. Find what works best for your organization. So it may make the most sense for when you're first creating your event to color code it then. But what if you want to change the color of an existing event after it's made? Simply right click on the event and pick your desired color. By the way, you will know which events originated from your primary calendar because you're still gonna have your primary calendar color right on the left-hand side here of that event. So you see here how I make all my YouTube edit tasks stand out in gray, while on the left of the event, it is pink. So I know that that's my primary calendar color. And you'll notice that for every single event on my calendar that is tied to my primary calendar, regardless of this color blocking that I've assigned it. So again, I can tell at one glance that this mom physio appointment is on a different calendar than my primary because it doesn't have my primary calendar color on the left of it. But you can set custom colors as well if you don't like these vibrant default colors. Click that three-dot menu icon to the right of the calendar that you want to change the color for, and then click the plus symbol under the default colors. Here you can scroll through the color slider, or you can add your custom color hex code. So you could add your brand color here for your specific brand calendar. But you might have noticed something else on my Gcal that I love to use to help me visually decipher a task. That's right, you can easily add emojis to your Gcal events to make your time blocking stand out even more. So when we create an event on Mac, we can hit Command Control Space to pull up the emoji picker. I think on Windows, it's the Windows logo key and period. But either way, we can select an emoji to add to the event title. You'll see I've done that with lunch and editing tasks. I even do it with vet appointments and other tasks. You can add them to whatever it is if it helps you with your time blocking. Now you might be wondering, well, this is great, but how do you, Tasia, actually figure out which days are scheduled for which things? Well, I'm glad you asked. It took me some time to work into this existing schedule. I often think of my Google Calendar like a workback schedule. If you're familiar with workback schedules in any type of production or project management, it's where you start from an end deliverable date, and then you build out your tasks backwards from there that would lead you to that end goal. So here's how this all helped me organize my Google Calendar. My starting point was quite literally my YouTube videos. This is the easiest place for me to start. Once weekly videos were a legit part of my workday, I realized they needed to be organized as such. So for me, my YouTube videos go live every single Thursday at 8 a.m. MST. As you can see denoted by this dark green calendar event color. So then I realized for about an hour before the video went live, it would be helpful to have some time for any last minute tweaks or time to schedule the YouTube video or rework a thumbnail or whatever it might be. So working back from there, I block out about 4 hours for a YouTube edit the afternoon before. And before you judge, yes, this is a ridiculously tight timeline, but I run a ridiculously tight ship. And if I have anything that is like a partnership or sponsored video, that of course gets reworked into the schedule for more timeline for reviews, I digress. Wednesday mornings work well for me for my YouTube video shoots. And then working back from there, Tuesday afternoons work well for my YouTube video scripts. So once my YouTube schedule was roughly built out on my calendar, I went to the next event schedule that I know is pretty much locked and loaded the exact same time every week. So this red block here is another client of mine. Every single Thursday afternoon is blocked for them. They have videos go live on specific days as well, and those are noted in my calendar. Our weekly Monday meeting is denoted here as well, and so on. These are pretty well fixed. So then from there, I add in another client where the work is more flexible and I can schedule it in between all of my other recurring tasks. You get the idea. Now, if you want to learn even more about sharing calendars or the time zones that you see here or some really helpful keyboard shortcuts, I have a whole bunch of other Google Calendar videos listed for you in the description below. In the meantime, happy time blocking and organizing your Gcal. So that's how I organize my Google Calendar. What do you think of these tips and how do you organize your Google Calendar? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here and here for even more Google Calendar content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.